Okay, everyone. Hey, I'm gonna do a video on a description of what I did to try to find sewage gas smells in my house. Going back about a year ago, I had just sewage stank in just about every room in my house, and through a process of elimination, I was able to determine what my problem was. And I'm hoping maybe for anybody out there who's trying to go through the similar process, this might be helpful to you. So I went through the normal things that you would do, right? So all of the bathrooms in my home see regular use, so I knew it wasn't the pee traps. We use all the toilets in the house. I knew that wasn't the problem. We use all of the showers. That's not the problem. I knew all of the pee traps in my house were full of water. I did replace every single air admittance valve in my home with a quality air admittance valve, and still the smells persisted. So the next thing I thought I had to do was a smoke test. You can pay companies to do that. It's expensive, but it's professionally done, and they'll do a good job. I tried to do it myself and came up with a solution that I'd like to try to describe the best I can. So I found a smoke bomb online, a product called Smokies. This is a 75-second smoke bomb. It's made by a company called Diversitech. The model number is 14175. These are hard to find online. If you do a search, there's a few sellers that sell this product. There may be something similar to this elsewhere. This is what I used. It's a pack of 10. 75-second smoke bomb, just about long enough to get the job done. What I did was, I took a tin can from a can of beans or a can of corn, I poked holes in the bottom of that, and then I lit my Smokies 75-second smoke bomb, dropped it into the can, then duct taped it as quickly as I could to the exhaust side of my shop vac. Okay, so that I could then blow that smoke. I'm just gonna head outside, so that I could blow that smoke through my sewage stack. So in my case, my sewage stack is outside here in my house, in my yard. I'll just point it out to you. Okay, so it's right here. I had to remove the cap and then put that shop vac exhaust with the smoke and blow that smoke down my sewage vent here. And then I try to stuff a towel around there so none of that smoke would back up out of the sewage stack there. So the thought being, I'm blowing that smoke into my house, and then I can try to do a quick visual inspection and see where that smoke's coming from, find the leak, right? So as soon as I just lit that bomb and I walked back into my house, here in my basement, I always had a smell down here. And sure enough, I had smoke coming from right up here in my ceiling. So, right here, I don't know if you can see it, but I have a pipe right there. Okay, and it dead ends. And actually, it didn't dead end. It was just sewage gas pouring out of there. Okay, so I capped it off. And now I no longer have a problem there. But what was interesting about the test that I did, and this is really the purpose of my video, is that the air that was blowing through my sewage lines caused a gurgling sound coming from my furnace. Okay, so you can imagine why I might have been sort of perplexed about why it was sewage gas causing noises to emanate from my gas furnace. So I thought about it, and here in my, now again, I'm in the basement of my home, but I have this is one of my sewage line center stack in the back of my house. Sewage comes right down here, down into there, and then out into the street, okay? But I also have a condensation line from my furnace that is, you can see the white line right there, okay? And it actually goes all the way along the wall here. You can see it, okay? I'm gonna turn my phone around. It comes along the wall. Here's the condensation line into my furnace, okay? So the condensation line is needed because when the furnace kicks on, generates heat, one of the byproducts is water. That water needs to go somewhere and drain somewhere. Well, in my case, the condensation line drained right into my center stack, my sewage line. Now, that would mean that sewage gases are free to come up my condensation line and right back up into my furnace and then blow that sewage stink throughout the whole house, okay? The way I resolved it was with this right here. Okay, so this is made by a company called Rectorseal. This is a P-trap designed for condensation lines, okay? So all I had to do was just snip my condensation line and install the Rectorseal, and now water just gets trapped, you know, down here into the P-trap of the Rectorseal, and that stops the condensation that's trapped in the P-trap, stops any gases from backing up into my furnace and then blowing into the rest of my home. So for anybody that is having issues with sewage smells in your home, again, look at your P-traps. Are they filled? You flush all of your toilets. Take a look at all of your shower stalls that are maybe not in use. Make sure they're all full. Do you have any air admittance valves? If so, are they the culprit? Replace them and see. But if you have a furnace, like I do, a gas furnace, take a look at the condensation line. Where does it terminate? Does it terminate into your sewage line like mine does? And if it does, well, then that's your issue. Get a Rectorseal, install that into your condensation line, and that eliminated the problem for me completely. It wasn't that difficult to install. I want to say that was probably 15 or 20 bucks for the Rectorseal, and the smoke bomb I think was like, I don't know, $30 if I remember. So I'm 50 bucks out, and I fixed the problem in my particular case. So hopefully that describes to you what I was able to accomplish in order to stop the sewage gas smells in my home. If you have any questions about, you know, more detail about what I did, feel free to give me a call. But it worked out great for me. So anyway, hope that helps you out. I'll include in the description some links where you can find some of the products I'm talking about. And let me know if I can be further help. Okay, thanks.